Back in the club car out of the U-Haul.
Okay, hit it. Okay, go forward. Go forward. Okay, now come back. You just gotta hit it. Gotta get up. Gotta get a rolling start. Okay, good. Go. Come on back. Come on back. Come on back. Just come on back. Okay, good. Come on back. You gotta get over. Yeah. Good job. Keep going. Go, go, go.
So here she be, the 1991 Club Car DS. This is the next legend. Now I don't plan to do any crazy engine modifications or any engine modifications at all, because believe me, it's got a ton of power as it is. And if I ever wanted more speed, I could just adjust the governor, which is, yes, it is adjustable. So this is pretty sweet. The body is just so much thicker than the one of my old Hyundai. Brand new windshield. Very thick glass or plastic. Some not factory, but they're mounted headlights, but they switch. Got an LED on it, so they are pretty bright. It's got four new rims and two new rear tires. Comes with hubcaps and slicks, which is weird. This has all been redone. It's kind of dirty now because I've been driving it around on the dirt road, but look at that, low oil sensor. That's pretty sweet, no smoking. It's got very nice steering. It's very tight, very precise, no play at all like my old Hyundai. There's no latch to open the engine compartment, so you just pull up. It's got a 341cc Kawasaki Flathead. Puts out about 8.5 horsepower, but like 14 something pounds feet of torque or more. So it's pretty sweet. It's got a 8-gallon gas tank and it's got the original belt on it, but that might need to be replaced sometime in the future. But it works fine. It's got the starter generator set up, so when you press the gas, the big electric motor turns the flywheel and starts it automatically. So it says it's a 91, because if you see right there, AG91, which stands for the year. And it's got the same mirror deal. No taillights, but that's okay. Metal bumpers. Yeah. Leaf springs. They're not coils, but it's all right. That is, it's a pretty stiff ride, actually. And a big muffler. It's got fender flares. That's pretty cool. All the bumpers and kick plates are metal, but insulated with rubber. And it's pretty sweet. It's fabric's a little bit chewed up. The previous owner, supposedly his dad, had peacocks and they would, I guess, bite into there or whatever. But no matter. It's got a instructions. It's got a, well, I'd assume it's, seems like it's metal and it's rubberized because it's very, very stiff and very, very tight. So it's got a little basket here since it's golf course prepared. Also, these straps, which I guess could be used if somebody rides on the back and they need to hold on to something, I guess they could loop their arm around this or whatever. But it's sweet. So I guess without further ado, let's take her for a spin. It's already warmed up, so no need for choke. It's interesting. So you just insert the key, turn it on. Normally, if it was cold, you'd hold this down for the choke, Then once it's started, that would pop right out and you're good to go. So it's got reverse, neutral, forward. So you just, what you do is just press the gas and you're off. It's very fast, very responsive. Runs very smooth. Suspension's a little stiff, but that's okay. The brake, get her in reverse. Turn all the way back this way. It's also got a low oil light, which is pretty cool. Oil was changed as well. It's got new oil. Don't want to go too fast over the bumps. I want to preserve this as much as I can. Got a cup holder, two cup holders. It's very fast. A lot faster than I expected it to be, to be honest. According to the owner's manual, this thing is only supposed to go between 12 and 15, but it seems more like 20 to me. Very cool. And all the all the members and everything in here were recently greased, as you can see. Came with a free semi-empty can of starting fluid. Because this is a flathead, flatheads are a little bit harder to start than overhead valve engines due to the fuel delivery design and everything. But that's okay. It's got great suspension for leaf springs. It's very stiff, which is, gives it kind of more of a sporty feel. But yeah, it's great, runs good. And it's very, very fun to drive.